Okay, today I'll make a video of some interior differences in Model 3 versus Model S, and also talk about some kinks that Model 3 came with that are typical for early production cars with Tesla. That was the case with Model S. These are, I'll just touch upon some major ones, and I'm sure Tesla will work those out over time, as it did with Model S. It will work out those issues with Model 3. And the main problem that I'm seeing right now is the right now I'm shooting from this phone, and it is supposedly it should open the car, and when I approach the car it should open and light up headlights and signaling that the car is open and I can enter the car. Right now, luckily, it remained open, but you can trust my word that that's not always the case. My wife and I have a Galaxy S7 phones, and it's an Android phone, and issues she and I have is whenever I approach the car, it will not work 100% of the time. I would say it just works maybe 30% of the time. The issue, I think, maybe with the Bluetooth protocol that have not been properly tested with Model 3 entry system, and they will not always detect the phone being in the proximity, in the area where it needs to open the car. My guess is that likely it was tested primarily on iPhones, and probably with iPhones, and I have to confirm this, with iPhones it works fine. And the reason that I think it was tested primarily with iPhones, and iPhones is the major platform that they tested with, is came with the by default the car came with this connector, which is for iPhone. It's definitely not Android, is not something that's favored in the Tesla world, so to speak. I remember that first application that they did was for iPhone, and then Android caught up. So my theory is that probably with it wasn't properly tested with Android phones. Android phones may be more difficult to get to work properly on the Bluetooth side compared to iPhones. Maybe not. That's just what I think might be the case, and just that I'm making an assumption here. But I would like to talk to some of the features that I'm gonna miss or not gonna miss from Model S, or early production car from 2013, and that car had some kinks, and people complained. I try not to complain a lot about this car. I still love the car, and I love it when it came out. There are some, some issues to deal with as early adopter, but that's the thing you need to understand, that when you buy a car that has been in existence less than a year, you should expect something like this. But being a strong believer in a electric drive train, and being much more superior to gas, just on the pure physics and logistics of delivering the fuel and producing the fuel that that powers the car, that I didn't look much at those things. And being not a car guy, not really a car guy, never owning an expensive car, and never wanting to own an expensive car like BMW or Mercedes, I didn't really care much about all the things, and I'm not really used to. And some people are used on expensive cars, so I bought this car just because it was electric and it was best electric car at the time. And I think under many criteria is still the best car. Anyway, I digress here. So what things are something that I will not or will miss
on Model 3, if I were to go from Model S to Model 3, which I am not going, this is not my car technically, this is my wife's car, so I keep driving that car, she will drive this. But if I were to go from Model S to Model 3, what are the features that I would miss? So let's look at the first thing. I've been showing this for a while, but the lack of a dashboard, the primary console cluster, dashboard cluster, just because it's not there, I would not miss it. I will miss only for the some information that would provide, and that would be GPS. Model S has an independent GPS that's independent from Google Maps, that can work without data. It's a standalone GPS, doesn't require data connection to work, so that's great. And so if you lose your connection, you will still get your GPS in Model S. Here, Google Maps most likely, well, that's on the phone case on the phone with Google Maps, is that you can cache the your route, and even if you lose connection, you will still be able to get there, and your map will be loaded from the cache. Here, it's just nice to have a secondary GPS, like two GPS systems in Model S. So it was really cool to have the redundant system. So on that part, I'm gonna miss that, but not for the cluster, because it provides me so much more visibility, and I don't really care about any additional, even though being the data guy and looking at the, you know, consumption, I don't really care about it much. I get some basic information on the consumption from here. Let's see. Here is that the only number I probably am mostly concerned with is, let's see if I can make focus here, the average consumption. So it's around 250 watt per mile. That's great. That car averages, if I don't drive economically, it's probably 330, 350, but if I drive economically, kind of saving efficiently, 300 is not out of the question. So 300 on that, 320 maybe, so 3 versus 248 here. That's a good efficiency. It's great. On my electric bike, I get maybe best when I can get 60 watt per mile, and this car is like what, at least 20 times heavier than a bike, right? So comparatively speaking, this is a great efficiency for a heavier car, for a car versus a very light 100-pound bike, electric bike, which I still get not really great efficiency. But that's due to the aerodynamics are not that great on this bike, on any bike whatsoever, compared to a car. Again, that's a topic for another discussion. Sun visors, much better, much more refined in Model 3. Not gonna miss sun visors on that car. There have been a lot of complaints, these things being kind of a narrow, which does not serve the intended purpose of blocking the sun sometimes. So you need to adjust that, kind of sit higher if you're a shorter person that has never been an issue for me. I'm not exactly a short person, being around 6 foot tall, so that, you know, and you can always adjust it with your dials here. Can't show it there, but you can adjust that. They're better quality, more refined. Definitely the overall finish is much better, and this is a premium version. That's what's available with for Model 3 currently. I think premium is the only one available as of today. Another thing I'm not exactly gonna miss, but this is a nice feature to have on Model S, is the panoramic roof that you can open, that you cannot currently open on Model 3. Maybe it will become an option over time. Right now it's just a panoramic roof, Not that I open it very often on this, on that car, maybe 10, maybe 5, 10 times a year. Nice feature to have, but not really something, not a big deal. So central console, Model S initially came without any central console, and then it became available as a part of the car, or an aftermarket option that people bought and retrofitted. I didn't have much trouble, you know, having a little mess here, and it wasn't bothering me that much. I would just clean it more often. With this central console, chances are that you'll put a lot of stuff here and it'll be just there bouncing forever and will not clean it, because you can't see the mess, right? Not the problem, but a good thing about that car is that you have your mess in front of you. Yeah, so it's like a sore thumb, and you clean it. Here, another thing is that this finish is prone to getting a lot of fingerprints, so you'll need to clean it. That's another thing. You will still need to clean it. But nice to have this phone area where you can put two phones. Actually, I ordered a charging pad, a wireless charging pad. You can put two phones here and charge them. We will see how that works, and I'll probably come up with another review of that, how that works. But it's nice to have this console and have extra space you can put, so you can hide your mess in. So that's good. Another thing, the seats, well, compared to the new Model S and X, these seats are probably as good, if not better, but at least as good. But this is expected to be a less expensive car versus X or S being a premium car. So seats have undergone much overhaul for the last few years in Model S and X. They're not what they used to be in the initial production cars. I never had complaints about my seats. I know a lot of people on early production Model S cars, they complain about seats a lot, but I'm not used to expensive cars, so I don't know what the cool great seat should feel like. It's good enough for me. What else? Nice to have these extra space. This is not something I'm gonna miss on Model S, a lack of this space. I'm gonna definitely like this. I would love this extra space where you can put your cup here, and there's a little bit of cubby here space. So these buttons, it's kind of cool, innovative. But I think I like the latch. So there's an emergency latch here, or you can still pull, but this is your main way to open the door. On Model S, you would just have a lever that you would pull and you open like in a regular car. I think that I prefer that more versus a button. It may be just a matter of habit. What else? Other than that, looks like more headroom in the front and in the back of this car, Model 3, more than in Model S. I wouldn't say there's much less space than in Model S. I think it's almost as in Model S. I mean, internally, this car is shorter just because it doesn't have a huge hatch like Model S has. But let's take a look. Let's get in the Model S and see some of the issues I have trouble with, but not that caused major inconveniences or problems, something I cannot work with, but something that just make a note of. Probably focus on things I'm not gonna miss. One of the major problem I had is with the placement of these
cup holders. So one big problem with this is that this is where your elbow is, right? If you want to put your cup here, you will inadvertently hit multiple times. And that's what I've done over the years. I would hit that if I have anything here, any coffee, whatever, I will hit it with my elbow. So that's the thing I'm definitely not gonna miss. Finally, I am very happy that Model 3, they didn't make this exact mistake of putting the cup holders here. Like I said, no copy space here. And I'm gonna just show briefly. So this is definitely looks like a little bit earlier design, and it's kind of just they needed to have them here by you know, by law. So the law requires that you have, so they put something here. Still works kind of, but it's not, there's no much width to block the sound. It still does, it serves the purpose. This one doesn't have lights, I believe. I don't use it often, but so that no lights here. Well, this is an early production car. Not something this may be available on the latest Model S. Like I said, room wise, so headroom approximately the same in the front. In the back, if you have a tall person sitting here, chances are they will be touching with their heads, they will be touching the ceiling, you know. So that's something that's less likely to happen in Model 3, as there's a little bit more headroom. One thing that I had a problem with also with Model S was this. So this trim, the problem with it, sometimes it gets like this. See, let me put this focus. So this, I think there was a problem with the supplier that they did this, but they said it's normal. When I talked to Tesla, they said it's normal. So this thing would be normal according to Tesla. So I dealt with it normal. Okay, if I don't pay attention to it, it doesn't bother me. But when I see it, bothers me a little bit. So what else? Yeah, like I said, GPS. So if you put a GPS search for location, navigate, and I want to go somewhere, like I can get all my information here. So this is great. But that's the expense of having this console here and having less visibility compared to Model 3. So again, so it's a matter of taste. If what you want better, more visibility versus extra data information, but I'm okay with either. Model 3 looks like a better choice for me, I think. I like the minimalistic design. And by the way, Model S happens to have a little bit more buttons here. So for example, glove box has an actual hardware button. Model 3, you would need to dig in the interface or the screen to find that. But takes only one or two clicks, though. I mean, taps on the screen. So, I think that's about it for now. Definitely, the cargo space that I talked about already is not as big in Model 3. So it's nice to have this space here. This is great. Same in Model S. So it's not exactly small in Model 3, but on Model S it's huge. And that's if you look at the Plus you can have seats here, right? So there's a lot of stuff you can put here. And we compare, while we're on it, compare the space in the front. So you have this microwave oven. I wish I could show this better, but you have your microwave oven here. There's a lot of space here. You can put right here. Sorry, you can see, can be seen, but that's a lot of space. You can put a lot of stuff there. With Model 3, I need to open the. Let me open it. So again, opening it from the screen or from the app. There's no button for it. So compare it to Model S. This is Model 3. In my car, my Model S doesn't have the dual drive or front drive. And that's why I have this extra space here. Model S with D dual drive will have that space all taken by the front motor. Here, even though it's interesting though, I think what happens here is that even though this car, early production Model 3 car, doesn't have a front drive, that space is already reserved for the front drive, and maybe just an empty space there. Yes, that's what it looks like. So they didn't bother to give that space back to the for the cargo, because it will eventually be taken by the front motor, and it's likely that they didn't want to go with redesign that for the dual drive. It's already designed for dual drive, so that space is effectively must be. I don't know for sure, but that's what it looks like, but it must be just empty space there behind the plastic, even though it can be used like in Model S, can be used for cargo. There's actually here some light there. There's an additional pretty good space there. You can put your carry-on luggage there. Okay, that's about it for now. Feel free to comment. Don't forget that you can have free supercharging for Model S or Model X that I provide their link for in below. And yeah, feel free to use it. It's nice to have free charging, which I get with this car, but unfortunately I'm not getting with this car. That would be great to have it with Model 3, but not an option anymore. Need to pay for it, not a big deal. Now that's gonna cost more, because this car is more efficient. Model 3 is more efficient. It's using at least 10-15% less energy to drive the same distance compared to Model S, for example, or Model X for that matter, even more efficient. Okay, that's about it. More to come. Thank you.